Medical team. I am Dr. Vivek Gupta from Apollo Hospital, New Delhi, with our team of anesthetists, Dr. Ramesh Chirgiri. Our nurses and the technical team and Sanal and everybody is there. So we have just finished a very complicated, I would say reasonably complicated case. Let me tell you the history of the patient. Patient had a recent, or I would say 5 days old, acute MI with LVF and cardiogenic shock. This patient presented to us after 3 days of sustaining an MI, which was more of a silent MI. Patient ECG showed left ventral branch block and with the blood pressure pending at 60 to 70 systolic. And of course, the patient was in pulmonary edema. We treated the patient in ICU for 3 days with NORAD, dopamine and other inotropes and LASIX infusion. And the patient, when the patient became comfortable, we did angiography after the 5th day of post-MI. And we saw the angiographic result. And the first shot, as you can see, is having a 100% occlusion of the LAD with a lot of thrombus. So this is very interesting because this patient had a thrombus in it. And this is the left dominant system with the disease also in a PDA. Next shot. So this is occluded LAD, you don't see LAD at all, some anti-grade flow and LA-caudal view. So it was a tricky case with the disease also in LPDA. The right coronary artery was occluded, which was also more of a non-dominant system. So we decided to come back. We discussed with our surgeon, with our team of anesthetists and also with our technician team, Mr. Basant. And we decided that since considering that it was an acute or recent or 5 days old MI, considering the high risk, the patient was also not ready. We thought of at least trying to open the LAD, which I was not very much clear whether I'll be successful or not. So I told the family that maybe it is working out, or maybe not be working out, then we'll do bypass surgery after a gap of few days. So we tried to cross this, and we had also a plan of thrombosuction. So I'll show you the first shot. We did a quick wiring, which was not difficult, with a whisper wire. And after this, we did a quick balloon dilatation by 1.5 millimeters balloon going to distally. So you can see that a lot of calcium. So we were always skeptical of the calcium. We did a good balloon dilatation with 1.5, then 2.25 balloon dilatation, 18 millimeter length all through. And we thought we had done a good dilatation. And then, but the overall flow was not so good. So we decided to do a thrombosuction. So this is the thrombosuction passes. Next view. We did thrombosuction. This is a thrombosuction export catheter, and we were not able to put it quite deeply. It was difficult, but finally we were successful to go deep. Next view, next. We had to go to the deep, and we found the result was much shade better after doing the thrombosuction. I'll show this. This come back here. Thrombus, the white thrombus which came out even after 5th day of MI. It is reasonably strange, but of course you have such a huge clot was there. The clot burden was quite good, and with the advice of our, I would say, Basant, I was not very clear whether we should do thrombosuction or not. So technicians are very important, and we did thrombosuction, and the result was good. We thought that it would be easy stenting, but it was not so easy. Next view, we took 3.3 millimeter into 38 millimeter stent because of high pack of calcium. It was not going through. Next view, next. Next, it was not easy, it was still in the left main. Next view. We did again dilatation. We thought, let us do another dilatation so that the stent passed through. Next, we took also two wires. Next, it was not going. So, next view. Next. After this, we took two wires. I think you have deleted a few of this. We took two wires. And with the two-wire technique, the stent was just at the ostium, and we thought of deploying the stent at this point. Next, the stent is deployed, and show me the final result. Yeah, but before that, let me show you. Have we taken the picture of that when the stent was stuck? It was not pre-dilating. So okay. So come back to me. But we had. We can show you one more view in taking out the stent after deploying it. But this is the final view. But before that, can we have another view just before this? No, just before this. Just before. Next, just before. No, okay. So come back to me. So with this, we used a Zeiss Alpine stent, and it was very difficult to actually make it fully deflated. And we had to use two more syringes, a 20 millimeter syringe, and then fortunately we had a thrombosuction syringe to further do a suction and try to remove the deflation of the balloon. The balloon was not deflating. I don't know why, but this was actually a problem. the first half of the proximal part of the balloon was not deflecting well, and finally we had to really very softly pull out the whole system, and it was, I think, partly deflated, that's why it came out. If it was fully inflated, the balloon will never come out. It can cause injury to the cornea, to this coronary artery, and it can be a serious problem. So we were lucky at two places. First of all, we were able to go through with the two wire technique, and secondly, we were lucky to pull out the partially deflated balloon, and which was stuck up, and despite the two big syringes of 50 ml suction, we were not able to actually really deflate it completely. So these are the two challenges which we had, but fortunately, with the luck of the patient, the blessings of God, we have done a good job and we have a good TIMI III flow. Show back again the last picture. Next, yes. So after removing the balloon, the whole system, the flow is fully maintained, and we have been able to do it right from the ostium till the mid LED, a good stenting with the Alpine Zyns stent. Why it was not deflating well, come back. One problem, we don't know. So, but we have to learn that if you have done a partial deflation with a deep throating of the guide, you can perhaps, we did a deep throating of the guide, but when the guide is almost there, so you can pull out the balloon with the whole system and we were successful. So the two messages in this case, that the export catheter is very important. In all cases, you have to follow the advice of technical team and other fellow members. It may take a little while to do it. Sometimes you have to be really patient to push it. It's not easy. It is a very soft catheter. And secondly, two wire technique to push the stent. And thirdly, if it is even partially deflated, you can really pull out. But of course, you have to be very, very careful, because if you're pulling out a fully inflated balloon from the stent, it will really cause injury to the whole system, and the patient will have a serious problem and no reflow and all those things. So this case of an acute 5 days old MI with a thrombosuction, with a longish stent, with a single vessel disease, we have done successfully. The pressures are well maintained, small inotropic dose, and we have done a good job, and I'm thanking you again to watching this video. Come back to me. Gupta from Apollo Hospital, New Delhi, along with Dr. Ramesh, our nursing staff, the name I always forget, and Mr. Basant, who is a very important technical team. Thank you very much for watching this video from Apollo Hospital, New Delhi, on 9th or 10th of January 2016.